It's currently 4:20 where I'm at, and that can only mean one thing. That's right. It's time for Mega Man X. Now, we start with this little intro sequence, little cutscene, a little bit more complicated than from the previous Mega Mans. What you're seeing right now is sort of the boot-up screen that Dr. Kane is looking at because he's trying to boot up Mega Man X. And if you don't know Mega Man X, here's the specifications. A bunch of shit that's going to pop up on the screen real fast, and you're not going to have enough time to read it, so you might have to go back and look it up. Nothing important, just that he's totally the bomb and the most awesome thing ever built. So, yeah. And then, you know, it's not even the fact that all this awesome equipment is outfitting this android. It's, the fact that he hasn't nearly met his full potential yet, which is scary. So this is the big warning disclaimer that Mega Man X has the ability of, you know, he has sentience. He can think and feel and make his own decisions. So apparently the original Mega Man didn't have any of those abilities. He was basically just a vacuum cleaner that can shoot people. He had no will of his own, which is kind of disappointing, because you kind of figure, like, he wanted to be a real boy. He seemed like he could make his own decisions. I mean, Proto Man was able to make his own decisions, for the most part, at least it seemed like it. No one really controlled him, but apparently X is different. X is completely different. He has complete mental faculties. He's basically human, except with titanium skin. So the warning is basically saying that Dr. Light built Mega Man X, but he built him many years ago, and he wasn't going to live long enough to see him coming out. And now, right off the bat, before I get started with this game, I'm going to have to change all the controls, because they totally suck, in my opinion. And if you don't remember, the layout of the SNES controller, which I'm currently using an Xbox 360 controller to play this, so I'll use that terminology. What I did was I changed the shoot button to the right bumper, and I put the dash on the X button and the jump on the A button, I think it is. And I put the pause screen on the Y button, and I put the change weapon button on the B button, which I don't use very often, but I put it there just in case. So you may be thinking, well, why would you put the shoot button, the most important button, on the bumper? Isn't it harder to do that with your index finger than it would be to do it with your thumb, especially that little bumper that clicks and clacks and stuff? Well, yeah, but the way I play, it doesn't matter. I get the job done. As you can see, you probably won't even notice. And by the way, I don't know if this was clear to anybody, but when I play through all the other Mega Man games, every time I play a game, I'm not using any of the cheats that you may see other people using. I don't use turbo buttons. I didn't use an auto dash button macro for Mega Man. I just played it with the default controls, the way it was meant to be played. I played it like a man. So maybe my performance isn't all that impressive compared to some of the robots out there, but I don't give a shit. I'm doing it because I love this fucking game, and I played the shit out of them. So I'm doing it for the internet. So anyway, as I was saying a while back, So Mega Man X was built, and he had, you know, complete mental faculties comparable to a human, all the regular emotions, except, you know, he was a crazy killer robot, or at least potentially he was. And so apparently Dr. Light, when he built X, he had some diagnostic program that he designed to be able to test and confirm that Mega Man X, the faculties were working properly, and that he would be good. Which, I guess, if you could confirm that his mental faculties are working, then you can't confirm that he'll always be good, because, you know, what is good and what is evil? No one knows. I guess, I don't know, maybe there was something in the past that he was trying to make sure that he wouldn't just completely go rogue right off the bat and start killing people. That he, I guess, yeah, that he would, his conscience would actually be working so that he would feel some repercussions for any negative actions that he took. Which I guess is the only real difference between X and the Mavericks. Which there is the little thing about, like, the Mavericks, because nothing was ever referenced about the Mavericks from the Mega Man, original Mega Man games. But there is the theory that the Robo-Inza, the disease that was spreading in one of the Mega Mans, is a prelude to the Sigma virus, or the Maverick virus. Whatever you want to call it. Which, the Maverick virus actually didn't originate from Sigma, it originated from Zero. And Zero was the product of Dr. Wily. But that's a whole complicated fucking backstory that we won't learn about for... This was 1993, I think. We won't learn about it for another 4 years, maybe. And even then, it's kind of sketchy. Which, actually, I'll get to it. When I play Mega Man X3, the ending cutscene in that game is really weird, because it explains all this stuff that completely throws you for a loop, doesn't make any fucking sense. And you're like, well, why are you telling me that? Why are you spoiling the rest of the X story? But then again, I never knew anyone in the history of the world that ever played Mega Man X3 until I fucking found a copy a few years ago. I mean, I actually knew people that played Mega Man X2. I used to have a copy of Mega Man X2. I don't know what happened to it. I feel bad that I don't have it anymore, because the shit goes for like $100 on eBay. But whatever. It's a good game. I'll be playing through all three of them. But now, I'll be playing through this game. So let's talk about this one. Right now, I'm starting with this stage, because you have to start with this stage. If you don't, then you're just doing yourself a disservice. And why is that? You're gonna find out in about 30 seconds. So right now, unlike Mega Man, the previous Mega Man games, you can't dash right off the bat. You gotta go your normal walking speed and just kinda deal with it. Which is exactly why I'm going here first, because this stage is gonna help me prevent that. So I never have to walk at this speed again. Now, when I was talking about changing the button layouts, the advantages to my button layout, I mean, I have the shoot button on a totally different spot than the other buttons. Wait, this really throws me up right here. I'm going to interrupt myself. Is that Dr. Light appears in an apparition, a holographic, to say, you know, I was hoping that you could, you know, I designed you so that you can make your own choices in life, and I was hoping that you would be able to live a peaceful life. And you could just, you know, you could be happy, you could be peaceful, you wouldn't have to fight or anything like that. Which is exactly why I designed you with giant fucking plasma gun weapons and titanium skin and these crazy hydraulics to move at the fucking Mach speed. That's exactly why I built you that way. I wanted you to have a peaceful, uneventful life. So I built you with a fucking gun. What sense does that make? I don't really get it. I mean, he didn't build Mega Man, like, on a whim. He wasn't like, you know, I'm gonna build Mega Man just in case something bad happens. No, he built Mega Man, or actually, he built Rock, which was his assistant, and he turned him into Mega Man at Mega Man's, you know, at Rock's insistence, because he said, I want to go stop Dr. Wily because he's ruining everything. And then Light was like, I don't know. I mean, are you sure? Because, I mean, we could just let the authorities take care of it. I mean, we could just sit in our hands. Like, no. Build me into a fighting robot. I know you can. I mean, look what Wily did to the other robots. Made them fight. And, you know, I know you could do it, so why don't you do it? And I'll go defend the good. He's like, all right. So in the past, you could assume that things kind of resolve peacefully, right? But just in case, Light built Mega Man X. And he's like, you know, I hope you have a peaceful life, but I built you with a gun anyway because I know the world's going to turn to shit. So I kind of gave you conscience and, you know, free will and thought just to kind of fuck with you. Because now you're going to be forced to defend, you know, life and good and the law and justice. You're going to be forced to defend them because no one else, nothing, no other entity on the planet is going to be able to stop the crazy shit that's going to come up in the future. Like Chill Penguin, for instance. But, you know, so you're going to have to do it. You're going to have to defend it. But I want you to feel bad for doing it because you don't want to kill people. Really? Thanks, Doc. I really appreciate that design choice. So now I get to kill people and feel bad for it. Brilliant. So, I have the dash attack now. And that's why I went to Chill Penguin stage first. Here's a little cool animation of getting weapon. And you can skip the animations now. So I want to show you it once. And then I'm going to skip the rest of them. So next I'm going to go here. Because I kind of have a thing I like to do. Where this game's a little bit different than other Mega Mans. Because you can go back to the revisit all the stages. And you collect all the items. Kind of like an RPG. You got to go collect the hidden items. And they make you stronger. So every level has one health tank, which increases your life bar. And every stage has... Is it every stage? No, it's not every stage. Most of the stages have at least either one sub-tank, which are like the E-tanks of this game, except you gotta fill them up yourself. Or they have... an upgrade armor part, like the, you know, the dash boots that I just picked up. And there's three other parts, one for armor, one for your blaster, one for your helmet. Which the helmet ones are always completely fucking useless. Except for Mega Man X3. Remember, that one's not so useless. So there, I just picked up my first sub-tank. And there's, I think there's one stage where they have a sub-tank and they have an armor upgrade part. And there's one stage that has neither. So it's not all perfectly divided, but you get what I'm talking about. So I like to go to stages, one in an order that makes them easy to beat, obviously. You can do it for this real fast. But also in a way where I know when I visit a stage, I can get everything in the stage in one trip and not have to revisit. And this stage, as long as you have the little dash boots, you can do that. Because you saw I got that first E-tank over in the corner at the beginning of the stage. Had to jump a real wide pit. And the same thing over here. I had to dash to get to this little compartment. Now this enhancement lets me break some blocks with my head. Which is great because I'm a robot and I can't get concussions, I guess. So why not let me break blocks with my head? You know, I could become a traveling circus freak. Like those martial arts people. But anyway, it's a completely useless concept. It's completely useless. You never use it for anything. I think, I'm not even sure, but I think maybe you need it to collect the next part I'm going to get. And that is pretty much it. Because I think you can't break those blocks. Which, you know, I break one of the sets I break with my helmet. The other one I break with my feet. I don't think you can break the blocks at all unless you have a helmet. But I could be wrong on that. So, if it's true that you can break the blocks with just your feet, you can just dash over and break them without needing to use your head, without the upgrade, then, yeah, this upgrade is completely fucking useless. But I'm getting it for 100% completion's sake. Which is what this playthrough is going to be. I'm going to collect everything as best as I can and show you where everything is. Except for, of course, you may know about the hidden Easter egg where you can get the Hadouken from Street Fighter. I'm not going to be doing that to save time, but I will explain where it is when I get there. So I'm just totally wailing on this motherfucker. I don't have his weakness. His weakness is the ability you get from Sting Chameleon. But you don't really need it. I mean, look at him. Such a wimp. He's got a nice rack, though. Big-ass nipples. Big robot nipples. And here's something really cool that only happens in this Mega Man X is when you beat stages, they adversely affect other stages. So as you can see, maybe it wasn't very clear on the background, but when I beat that stage, I was on top of a giant airplane carrier or something, right? Maybe it was a battleship. And when I defeated Storm Eagle, the ship fell from the sky. And when I get to Spark Mandrill stage, this stage will be completely different, and most of it will be way easier as a result, because the plane fell on his power plane. Now, here's another example, is after I beat Chill Penguin, all this shit froze over. So all of the places where you see ice, it was lava, and it was doing a fuck ton of damage, but now it's not, and I can get through the stage way faster. Now this jump is really hard to make, and you gotta do it just right, because if you slip off, you gotta restart the level and do it over again, because there's no way you get up there without using those blocks as leverage. Luckily, it didn't take me 10 minutes, so now I'm up here. And this is a completely optional thing, by the way, which all the parts are optional, but this one, if you play through the game, I'm sure you're familiar that you will get this upgrade automatically if you play through the game. But I'm showing you where it is in the normal game. Ta-da! The Charge Blaster. And they're making me show you how it works, so there you go. I'm using this ability, because it's a totally sick-ass ability. It kills pretty much everything in the game in one shot. Dashing the little heart piece, which, you know, as I was saying, why I'm doing these levels in a certain order, because if I didn't kill Chill Penguin first, then that thing wouldn't have been, that would have still been hot, deadly lava, and it would have hurt me, and I wouldn't have been able to get that heart piece. So there you go. So now, I'm going over here, little optional area, get the sub tank. Second sub tank. So, there it is. And now, I'm done. I can just dash to the end of the level. I'm trying to collect health items along the way to refill those tanks. So those tanks are empty as shit. And they're completely useless when they're empty. So hopefully I can fill them by the time I need them. Which hopefully won't be until the very end of the game. Because this game is pretty easy. At least I think so. Definitely compared to the other Mega Man games, or the Mega Man X games, it's pretty fucking easy. Especially when you get all the upgrade parts. Which I'm not going to get the last one until pretty much the end of the first half of this game. But it's not a big deal. It's not much of a problem. Everything in this game is pretty easy to dodge. So now you got this really big open field to fight this guy in. And he's kind of big and slow. But that's okay. Just kind of wailing on him. Double hitting him with each hurricane blast. Taking fireballs in the face like a boss. So I don't give a shit. Does hardly any damage. And I really like the little explosion animations where they just explode for like 20 minutes and then they just completely disappear. It's way cooler than that fucking, they instantly explode into a bunch of life bubbles and you just absorb them.